Mardi Gras, absolutely. My mom will appreciate that too, Vaughn. I don't know if you know, but my mom is from Louisiana. Her life story, actually, you can find it documented in a an historically accurate movie that we like to call Waterboy. So if you've ever seen that, she was actually at the party. You remember after they won the big game, and they went to that party, and they were there with like the crawl the alligator. Muffins. My mom was actually in that at that party. She felt so strongly about that documentary that was being published that she was an extra in the movie. So, yep, you can see her in the movie. It's great. It's great. She's obviously not here right now because she would be getting very angry with me. But maybe she's come to accept it. But she is from Louisiana, but does not like the water boy. And we always troll her with that. So, yeah, I think Mardi Gras is good, Bon. Love some gator on a stick? You can do it! oh, this snake is delicious. What part is this? Well, snakes don't really have parts. But if I had to guess, I'd guess it was his knee. Oh my goodness. The medulla oblongata. Mama says the medulla oblongata, that the alligators are so ornery because they has all have all them teeth and no toothbrush. I gotta go. Thanks for the stream, Boyd. Y'all have a good night, Tatum. Have yourself a good night, bud. If you're heading off to eat some
Number
dinner,
44.
yeah, get some
44,
lunch
that's
meat
me.
too. I'll take some pastrami.
Get some cold
Thanks,
cuts.
buddy. Hey, talk to you later, Tatum. Have a good night, buddy. Baby Mardi Gras hype. That's what I'm talking about, Vaughn. If baby, and maybe, you know, maybe we can get an advertisement with Popeyes because of our you know, we named our baby after the Mardi Gras mustard and our love for it. Maybe we can get some advertisement spots and get some free Popeyes. You think that's a possibility? I think we should contact them and let them know. They've gotten a lot of screen time because of us and promoting their products. Now naming our child, our one and only child, after the Mardi Gras mustard. That's dedication. So I feel like we should contact Popeyes and see what they can do for us. I'm trying to. This is a really difficult part of the bowl to get this curved here and get that bottom slanted. The corner is not perfect, but I feel like there's not much else I can do with the gouge. So we're gonna have to lean on our sandpaper a little bit for that one. But that's fine. That's fine. We'll get to it. Just need to take off a little bit more here. Start blending that bottom. Okay. I don't see why not. We need a heavy sponsorship. Absolutely. Absolutely, Vaughn. We all deserve some sponsors here on Twitch. Nobody cares about us little people here. We deserve sponsors just like the big streamers. So 100%. And I think Popeye's, I mean, look, together we all add up to a lot. So, and we have a ton of enthusiasm for the Popeye's brand. I'll eat Popeyes every single day on stream. Yeah, maybe that's a lie. I think at some point, if I don't get sick of Popeyes, my body is going to tell me no. I don't think that's actually safe, but once a week, twice a week on stream, I will eat Popeyes. I will say amazing things about them. And I think it's going to be a great relationship that we've got with Popeyes. I can already see it now. I'm a little scared. This is seeming a little thin right here. Let's hope not. Still got structure to it. We're still good. We're still good. Alright. So, let's just finish this thing out. Let me go sharpen real quick. Camera 4. Vaughn, what games you been playing recently? And trust me, you got Popeye's chicken fingers, or maybe, I mean, their fries are amazing. They're also a little greasy. Don't be greasing up your keyboard just for me. But I have seen you on in the early mornings. Playing some games and stuff. What have you been playing recently? Have a scraper? I guess I do, Random Tinkerer. I do have a little scraper, but it's a... And I always forget about the scraper. It is a... This one here, and technically, most of the time I cut with that side down, but I wonder if I could... You know, I don't see why not. If it catches that corner, though, if it catches that corner right here. You like the rounded corner on the inside? I think that's all I could do, Walnut. I don't know if I could actually get it anymore, but I'm glad you like it. I'm glad you don't like it, because I don't think I could do the other way around. Is this thing still spinning, Momo? Yeah, but it'll slow down. It's off, at least. It just it takes a second for it to slow down. They're always sleeping on a smaller fault, missing out on their part. That's what I'm saying. I don't know. I guess some, you know, there are some good Stream Element sponsorships that are going around. Random Tinker is actually, if anybody wants to sign up for HelloFresh and wants to support somebody in the community who is doing HelloFresh, if you've never tried it out and want to, hashtag not an ad for me, but an ad for Random Tinker, go check out his streams, and he's got a current promotion going on. But there are some opportunities, I guess, and through Stream Elements and elsewhere, but kind of few and far between. Still getting comfortable with that part of the bowl. Yeah, this is definitely when I can make a funnel. What I mean by a funnel is putting a hole in the bottom, right? Because we're pretty deep at this point. See how far my finger's going in. We're right down working in this area. If I accidentally go a little too deep, we go through the bottom. So, what's up, Cosmic Giant? Welcome in. All is good here, bud. Just working on this bowl. It's a cherry 7x3 bowl that we got going, and trying to get the bottom of it worked out. But how are you doing today, Cosmic Giant? So much power, yeah. It spins really fast. I guess relatively, it's supposed to be a low speed, but still spins at 1700 RPMs. I have a napkin. I've been doing a mix with Just Chatting and Art lately, but I started a point and click game today. That came out yesterday. Awesome. That's fun. And glad you're getting some art in there too. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Need more artists that I follow and can support as well. I mean we've got a few, but I don't venture into the art category just like looking for streamers. It's pretty much only people who I know from the community or who like we raid into and stuff. So I need to do more of that as well, because probably a lot of great people over there who I just don't follow yet. But yeah. Sure, Random Tinker. Chilling, solid up, blanks all morning. Awesome. What kind of blanks you got going, Cosmic Giant? You doing like pen blanks or something else? Have I ever tried a bottom bowl gouge? I haven't. If I know or understand correctly, instead of having a fingernail grind, it's got a very short, stubby grind, right? How long is the bowl gouge usually when you first get it? Long, Leah. I don't have. Yeah, pretty long. The flute, is this this cutout part here. This is another bowl gouge that I've got, and yeah, that's pretty aligned. You can see that this one's got. I mean, this one is used as well, but it's got at least another inch and a half or something on it. So something that can help reduce the amount that you take off with each sharpening is you can see that this wheel over here is different than this wheel over here. This one is white. This one is stainless steel or whatever. This one is called a CBN wheel. And basically it's got embedded, not diamonds, but essentially pretty much like diamonds on the surface. And this one doesn't wear. You can use it forever and it just stays in its current shape. Where this one, the aluminum oxide, I think that's what these are. They will eventually wear down. You have to true them up and stuff. But the CBN takes off a lot less material per sharpening than the aluminum oxide. So I did start off with both sides being aluminum oxide, but upgraded to the CBN. And it is like a, I don't know, $150 upgrade or something. So, but it does help. You know, you save a lot of tool life because of that. Just got into watercolor and it's been fun. Nice. Goodness, I am so not artistic. So I love that you're getting into it though. It just takes practice, right? And like watching other people, learning different techniques, just like everything, right? So, and Vaughn, you're already so creative as it is. I'm sure, yeah, I don't think I've been able to see any of your art yet, but I definitely want to check some of it out soon. So, yeah, good, awesome. Let's give a shout out for Ask Vaughn as well. Typically streams in the mornings, does some gaming, but as she's saying, she also has been getting into some art with some watercolors as well as just chatting. And if you've never chatted with Vaughn, she is amazingly personable. So much fun to just hang around, just like a bright, shining a person who is always happy and a pleasure to talk to and be around. So go follow Ask Vaughn. Give her some chins if you're a sub to Babe Ross as well. Give her some chins, and that will make her day that much better. Vaughn, I'm very sad right now. I've got to tell you something, Vaughn. Please don't be too disappointed with me. Please, I'm asking for your forgiveness. But please forgive me whenever I say that unfortunately... Oh, it does look like here on this computer, but 50 on my inside computer, which is my main computer, chin has slipped to my number two most used emote. The science heart, the ant heart that is animated has unfortunately slipped to number one. And I can only blame science because he's always making me blush with his compliments. And it's become one of my favorite, and I guess technically now it is my favorite emote to use. But the science heart, this one here, has become my number one used emote. So I'm very sad. I noticed that last night. I'm like, damn, Bond's gonna be disappointed in me. I haven't told anybody until right now either, but I got to step up my chin game. I think I got to 1500 chins last year. I think that was the count, but I gotta step it up this year. We gotta go for 10,000 chins. Perota logs into large ball blanks. Perota. Oh, and it's stubby. Is that what you typically use, Cosmic Giant? I've seen those. But yeah, right now I'm just working with that 3/8 inch ball gouge. And I haven't bought anything else yet. What I do, and I should have done it, I kind of forgot on this one. I'll do a second bevel. You can see it. I did it for the last ball that I made. But I'll create this second bevel down here. Again, another trick taught to me by Caps Creations. And we'll kind of shorten the main bevel, and that way it's a little easier to turn corners. I should have done that on this one, but you can see that the second bevel at the tip there is essentially gone. So, yeah, I didn't get much help from that. Appreciate you. Thank you for the shout-out. Of course, Vaughn, of course. I mean, Science does have super cute emotes. I love his emotes. But thank you for the chins in here too, Vaughn. I love the chins. Momo, not so much. But I don't know. There's something about the chin. It's just got a certain energy to it. That you can just feel it. You can just feel the vibrations of the chins. know, this is super pretty. I've never heard of Perota wood. Tropical exotic hardwood. Yeah, it's beautiful. Looks kind of similar to walnut, but some lighter wood in there too. Yeah, those slabs. Damn. I really wish I had a bigger shop and I would like to work with slabs, but I don't have any place to store slabs and finished slab tables or anything. You're out of chins right now, RT. Shame. That's a shame. What up, Free Fall? That's a lot of yuck in three emotes there, Free Fall. Started finishing the bottom of the bottom gold gouge. Leaves a super nice finish, but it's tricky to learn. I bet. Yeah, because I'm so used to this fingernail grind that it's just kind of like natural to me. But I do have that. Dang it, do I risk? All right, we're going to risk it here. Because my bottom, I mean, not my bottom, but the bottom of this bowl is not great. It's going to require some 80 grit sanding if we don't clean that up some. Where did I put that? Where did I put that scraper? Damn it. Where did I put it? Oh, there it is. There it is. Don't you yeet this. No, Risky. I love this bowl. I think I can do it. I think I can do it without too much risk. Oh, sorry if that was an earthquake. Had to tap out some dust. Why does this not want to go in? Too good for your home, scraper? Oh, that's way too loose. I can't use it like that. Huh. Do I have another? I think I lost. Here's another handle. Maybe it fits this some better. Oh, there it goes. There we go. All right.
You like turning more than slab work? I've never done it before, so I'll take your word on it. Yeah, that's good to know. I always see people doing slab work on YouTube, and it makes me jealous, but good to know maybe it's not all it looks to be. Now, the risky part is if I turn this thing upside down, slab work is 90% just sanding. I can tell you, I've had enough of sanding. Tuttle, thank you for that follow. These damn end grain cutting boards over here that I'm making. I don't know if you've seen these, Cosmic or whoever, but these damn end grain cutting boards are about to break me on sanding too. I love the look. I love making these up to the point of sanding, but holy shit. Is sanding in grain a pain in the ass? Especially, I thought I got a new Merca sander too. I probably should have gone with a 6-inch, but I didn't want to ask for too much. It was a little trade for doing the Lee Valley stream, and I didn't want to ask for too much, so I only asked for the 5-inch. And I'm using Abernet. I'm trying to do all the things right, but damn. Thanks, Cosmic. Appreciate it. Yeah, I like turning. I don't like sanding. Oh, shit. Please don't yeet. I've got this tool upside down right now. I don't even know if y'all can see. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's not meant to be used this way. For sure. We may just sand it. All right. Well, yeah, I think that's as good as it's going to get. It did improve it some. It's a little more flat, at least in this area, than it was. Out here, it's still rough. But I don't think there's much I can do with that. And we're getting pretty thin now, where I'm going to be scared to take off any more material, so We'll just go in the middle and do this.
We'll sand for snacks?
I don't think so. You would maybe sand the first time for some snacks, but then the next time you sand, I think you're going to be asking for more than that, because not all it's cracked up to be.
Can you program the CNC to sand?
There are... I've looked at this for a long time. There are modules, or there are things you can put in the router that claim to be CNC sanding pads, right? Problem is, they're all like $750. A lot of money. And some of them have even been discontinued, and I'm speculating because they don't work very well. Because everywhere that I check, like try and reading forums and stuff, talking about the CNC sanding options, none of them have good things to say. So at one point I tried to put a little 2-inch pad. Do I have one? Whatever, kind of like this. It's got a little stem, but it was a 2-inch instead of a 1-inch. And I accidentally set the Z depth a little too low, and it ripped off the sanding pad and then ruined the hook and loop behind it. And after that, it was essentially useless. So I've tried it, but I don't know. I haven't been successful with it. If somebody else knows of a way or has a recommendation on it, we'd love to hear it. But I don't think that there's a good way to sand on the CNC. Router spins too fast. You would have to fit a sander somehow. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, potentially. I mean, it would be good to look at, just in the point of like, I don't know, trying to find a way to save time. But maybe with my old orbital sander, I could give something a try. But yeah, I think that's like the only way. I think the problem still exists that you want a very light touch when using an orbital sander, and getting that light touch on a CNC is not something that's easily programmable, I don't think. I'll give you snacks if you sand for me. That's what I'm saying, Cosmic Giant. Wonder how many snacks you would get for 20 minutes of sanding? I don't know. That's a pretty good amount. If you're straight sanding for 20 minutes, but I swear on those cutting boards, and I've even got a drum sander that's set up with 120 grit. I still have to sand those. I've got an hour into each one of those already, and they're not done. They're not done. So. Yeah, it's not easy. I've talked about maybe getting a 220 grit belt for my drum sander and trying to process them with that, but I haven't jumped through that hoop yet. I haven't went out and bought the paper. My current problem right now is my router for my router table is not working, and I've got to get that fixed first. That's a good offer, I'd take it. Maybe some chips, a sandwich if I'm lucky. Ever had Dots pretzels? Those are fire. I'm with you on Dots pretzels. Take a break from this dust collector. Whenever I stream for hours and the dust collector is going for that long, I think I start yelling and then I have a headache by the end of it. Just take a second to get sand. All right, we're back. I used the Dremel with a rotary saw attachment yesterday to cut some acrylic, and that was slightly terrifying. I had to take breaks because the acrylic was melting. Oh, with a rotary saw attachment. Oh, I know what you're talking about oh, yeah, you like the haircut, Vaughn? I wasn't really intending on it being this short all the way through, but
You know, I found out that hairstylists make their money, at least on guys' haircuts. They make their money on transitioning from the short sides to the long top. And, well, I think I did a pretty good job shaving the sides and then scissor cutting the top. And Walnut came in and helped me finally as well. Yeah, trying to get this transition right. The fade from the short to the long. It was just like either super poofy on the side, looking like a mushroom, or I don't know. We just couldn't get it looking right. So just full sent the razor right down the middle, and this is what we were left with. So thank you. I'm glad I don't look too dumb. I definitely look different, and it took me a while to recognize myself in the mirror. But yeah, the hair like being past my eyes was super like was driving me insane. So I do have isotunes, Momo. And they do help, but it's still, I think it's the constant noise. Oh, sorry, I thought that was a shame. The constant noise and it being pretty loud in here, I think just overcomes it. So, but yeah, the Mama, probably the, I don't know what the best table saw would be nice for you to cut those sheets, or a band saw. I don't think you have either of those. So, yeah, it's tough. That's tough to not be able to fit it in the Glowforge. Not sure. Pretty banging. I think it might be a Midwest thing. I got them from Menards and gas stations. Yo, Ned, whenever I visited my brother in Kansas for the first time this year, or last year, I mean, I went to a Menards for the first time, and it was awesome. I loved Menards. So it's such a good variety of tools, so well organized. Like, just seemed like a steps up from a Home Depot or a Lowe's, right? Just like, I don't know, way better. I felt way more comfortable in there than Home Depot or Lowe's. So only have one router wrench, be so disappointed. Technically, Random Tinker, I do have another what's this called, DeWalt router here, but problem is I think I do have a plunge base for it as well, but I don't have the holes in the router table don't line up with the holes on the Triton. So temporarily, maybe I'll just have to use this to like, to hand round over edges and stuff. But I do need to, I was saying earlier that I think the technical support helped me, and they also think it's the speed controller. So I think we're going to try and replace the speed controller soon, but they got to check and see if it's under warranty first. A 3D printed device that clamps a common sander onto the CNC finder, create a very soft sanding pad for the sander. Buy a hot tub. What does buying a hot tub have to do with any of this free fall? But you're right. I think that is one mistake. Whenever I tried this previously, I just had a hard backed sanding pad, as opposed to a soft foam one. What happened to that little 1-inch? Oh, there it is. So I did have, it was one like this, that's just kind of the hard yellow foam. And so, yeah, whenever it pushed down and was put a little too much pressure on the surface, the sandpaper flung off, and again, it ruined the hook and loop. But you're right that I really should have had some sort of foam backing like this that's very squishy. And if I did go down a little bit too far, worst case is maybe it leaves some deep scratch marks, or, I don't know, compresses it a little too much. It shouldn't ruin the whole pad or maybe damage the machine. So you're right. Do I have thinning shears? Maybe helpful. That's what the hairstylists use, but I cut my hair when it's that long. Go bald or go home, or both in my case. No. Bald wouldn't be a good look on me, and I don't look like just keeping up with my beard and shaving the tops and the bottoms. That's like all I can keep with as far as hair management, and keeping it relatively trimmed. I couldn't keep up with shaving my head bald every day. That'd be way too much. Teddy needs his thinning shears. Yeah, I need some for Vince as well. Not sure how the CNC in general handle the vibrations of an orbital sander. That is true. That may be kind of damaging to the CNC as well. Although, you know, it's not exactly calm whenever you've got a router bit running through there. But yeah, maybe like the hours and hours of sanding vibration may not be great for it. That's a good point. I haven't really considered freefall, but never realized how full your eyelashes are. I'm so jealous. Yeah. I don't know. It's the mascara. Mascara. Is that the right one? Yeah, it's the mascara that I use, Ask Vaughn. It's the Boyd special mascara. You can find it on the website. We do sell it for a discount to Twitch subscribers. So you can check it on the website. Just search for the mascara and it'll help. No, stop making me blush. Stop making me blush, everybody. Where's the link? Oh, I'll find it. I'll find it and I'll send it to you. It may be a private listing because I can't be sharing all my secrets with everybody. But for you, Vaughn, just special for you, Vaughn. I'll sell you some of it. Oh my goodness. All right, stop making me blush. Stop making me turn red. Where were we? This was my first bowl gouge. Y'all were talking about the length of the bowl gouge. This was the first one that I had. Again, all sharpened with the aluminum oxide wheel. We're not quite. I've still got a little more length on my Thompson, but yeah. The other thing is the Sorby, the steel in the Sorby bowl gouge isn't quite as hard as the steel in the Thompson. So the Thompson requires a few less sharpenings, and whenever you do sharpen it, it doesn't wear away as quickly as the Thompson. So, but yeah, it did free fall. It was crazy. I was turning from all the way back here whenever it first started. It started like, you know, I could have some distance, and it was very safe, right? You could turn, the chips would go that way. And it was really nice, but slowly we started inching our way up, and then finally it got down to this length. So, yep. I need to find a lash oil to get lashes like that. Boyd's lash oil may be the solution for you, Vaughn. Has not been tested by the FDA, so I can't make claims like it's 100% guaranteed to make your lashes more full and looking the best ever, but you know, I just demo it for myself, and I just let the results speak for themselves, Vaughn. So take it as you wish. Mascara is the one you're thinking of. Eyeliner is the stuff. Oh, okay. Yeah, I should know this stuff, but you know, Walnut's my sales rep, so she does all the heavy lifting. I'm uncomfortable talking like this. I'm uncomfortable talking about myself being a model or something. But the freaks will help distract me from all this. I can't talk anymore. I think I need some water. How are we doing today, Freaky? Welcome in. How are we today, Freaky? I saw you were doing a little work on your bookends. If y'all aren't following Freaky, he has returned to streaming this week and has done, I think, 3 streams in a row, right? If I remember correctly, yesterday you were saying that today was going to be your last stream and you were going to come back next week. But make sure you're following Freaky. He has an amazing idea for his bookend. Let me see. This is maybe a little bit older picture, but check out these bookends that Freaky is planning to make. Wait. Oh, okay. But yeah, today and yesterday he was he's working on the plane first, the plane being the left one over there. He's got a piece of brass. I saw you shaping, I think it was the sides, right? Maybe the sidewalls. Today that you were filing down a little bit, so of course, the Craftsman's Guild, our Discord, our stream team, and we have a what am I trying to say? A quarterly challenge. And the topic for this challenge is bookends. So, yeah, if you guys didn't know, if you're not a part of the Discord, make sure that you check. Thank you, Momo. Momo, best mod. Go check out in the Discord. And if you haven't joined yet, make sure that you go to the role selection tab, click some of the emotes to populate the other channels, and then go to the community challenge section where you can see more information in the pinned messages up here. Shanigans has all of the rules and info here. So entries are due by the end of February. So you still got about a month and a half, but what's up? If you want, or we can put it in the fridge for... Sure. Why don't you just put it in the fridge and let it sit overnight? I don't know. Read the instructions and see. But yeah, Freaky's been working on some of those, some parts for this. He's going to start with the plane, I think, and then maybe do the chisel and see if those are both feasible and then work on the remaining parts. So if you haven't joined yet, if you haven't started on your project like myself and you're planning to enter, we gotta step up our game because Freaky is bringing it again this time. So looking forward to that. Thank you, Freaky. Everybody was starting to make me too embarrassed talking about eyelashes and stuff. So thank you for coming in and saving me, Freaky. Appreciate that, buddy. Always here for me when needed. So thank you. English is very hard for me today, Leah. I don't know what's gotten into me. I need a German English translator. Anybody know where I can get one of those? I need a guy who has experience reading instructions in English, but is also German. But helps read instructions in English. Anybody know where I can find somebody like that? I don't know. We're gonna have to look around. Hotel. Why are we doing that one? Very nice. Very appropriate for the guild. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely charmed. If you guys didn't see Freaky's wand, he did. He did an amazing job on that. Incorporated a lot of different techniques to get it done. And he's going to be doing the same here. So, yeah, he's streaming it. Or he has streamed it this week. And, you know, hopefully we'll be back next week and showing some more of his process. So I really look forward to seeing the progression and how it all comes together. So maybe he can teach me how to make chess boards after it too. Looks like there's some chess pieces that are going to, or chess board on the bottom. That's going to be part of the design. I really can't talk today, guys. I apologize. My brain is just seems to be mush. I blame chat for how the stream started today. Pretty boy Boyd? Goodness. Shaping brass, it's going to look amazing. Yeah. Especially like all polished up too. It's going to look real good. Lurk, but I should be back soon. Sounds good, Vaughn. Thanks so much for stopping by for the resub earlier. And yeah, maybe we'll talk to you later. No you, high tech. No you. That Freaky's ploy to intimidate everybody out there by having the only entry? Maybe, and it may just work. Free fall. I don't know what I could possibly think of that could compete with that. So I really need to like get on something soon. But yeah, if I don't start soon, it's gonna be another last minute effort. And you guys got to remember, February, short month, and I don't know if it's a leap year or not, but even so, maximum 29 days. And we gotta remember that and make sure that we don't wait till the absolute last minute. Got fewer number of days, just telling. Yeah, definitely, Freaky. Yeah, for sure, show the wand on Monday. If y'all haven't seen it, it's a masterpiece. Can't read that random thinker, so I'm assuming that goes to Freaky. Not even going to try to pronounce it, because I'm just going to make a fool of myself. We're using 120 grit here. Try to reduce the number of standing steps, so
We'll see if that gets out all the scratches or not. We're doing okay for now. Relatively fresh piece.
Yeah, it's working pretty well, so he should be able to do the a little bit more in the corner than the sidewalls, but yeah, it's coming together pretty well. Pretty good. Drink some more water. I got really dehydrated. What did we stream for, like 5.5 or 6 hours on Tuesday? I drank very little water. And yeah, typically whenever I'm super dehydrated,
I have very lucid dreams. And I was definitely having some on Tuesday night.
Arkiros is here. What's up, Arkiros? Welcome in, my friend. Thank you for the lurk, buddy. Yeah, hope you're having a good one, Arkiros. You're carving. Oh, is hot mama something mama. Mama, are you still here? Not my actual mom, but mama the screen chat. Someone else, screen name, I mean. Someone else who carves in the community is Arkiros here. Someone was asking about a custom carving earlier in the stream, but I don't know if they're still here or not.
Anyway, you're not another carver. Somebody who wanted a carving. And I was pointing them in the direction of Wakeful Wood and some others, but Arkiro is somebody who streams later in the evening, typically. Amazingly talented carver. And he's working on a stone
wall with an arch. It's got a special name. Maybe Arkiro can remind us, but he's the Bermuda Moongate. Thank you. Thank you. Super cool. If y'all haven't checked on the progress of it, he was in the stage of carving it maybe last night or a couple nights ago whenever I was hanging out in there. He said he's also going to paint it.
And it's looking just stunning. And whenever you look at the actual picture and then look at his carving, it's almost identical match. So a very, very talented carver. In Arkiros, he's made Pokemon before, and dogs, and all kind of stuff in a 3D way out of wood. Super impressive. About to start painting it. Nice. I know, Lee. I'm trying. I've been bad boy.
Bad boy.
Thanks for being here, Arkiros.
Anything in wood. That's right. Anything.
Whatever you can dream of, Arkiros can make into a reality. Yeah, I'm excited too, Arkiros. I remember you mentioning that you said maybe soon you're going to be able to fire up your lathe and maybe get a few lathe things in. That would be awesome. Love to see it. Yeah, your work making those
railings and stuff looked really good back in the day, so. Except people suck. Yeah, I feel like making a person and, like, I don't know, like painting a person or whatever, it's so hard to, like, get the proportions and the facial features and stuff, all of that right without making it look weird, right? A dog, you can be a little bit off and
things will look okay, but, like, I don't know, I'd be so scared of making, like, a person's teeth too big or their eyes too big or not centered or something that I don't know. It would just look weird or something. I can definitely see that. Wait, yellow JP for not drinking water on his streams? Yeah. It's important, and like you don't realize how long you can be streaming without drinking any water, so why I reward you guys for hydrating me with a few extra elements point.
Yeah. Blue Moon started that, by the way. Thank Blue for always reminding me to hydrate, even whenever it didn't give you channel points or stream elements points for it. You mean carving a person sucks? Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I meant.
Well, I think that's what Arkiros meant too, but I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I think so. Arkiros is a nice guy. We've seen your dinosaurs.
Are you talking about paintings? Are you talking about my paintings, Freefall? Don't make me bring those up on stream right now.
Actually, really, don't make me bring those up on stream right now. I don't wanna live through that nightmare again. That used to be the battle dinosaurs. I might be.
Animals got it right. You can tell in the first 5 seconds the animal's gonna bite you, but I've had friends for decades that always show the true colors. Animals went with you. Okay, maybe Arkiros wasn't talking about carving, but no, Arkiros
is somebody who very kind on scene, so don't be intimidated by this. Well, no, I get you.
I like people too, I just don't like carving them. Yeah. It depends on what my mood is. I might bite within the first 5 seconds, if you mean.
Kind of like a dog too then.
All right, I gotta eat easy on the sanding because I don't want to sand through this thing. We're creating a lot of sawdust here, so make sure wall thickness is still good. Yeah, it's still good. It's getting there. It's getting there. A few little scratches in that corner still, but yeah, it's feeling pretty smooth. A little bit of tear out right there as well. We're slowly.
Not the most exciting part of the process, but it's an important one. Freefall, don't be reminding me of drawings and paintings whenever I'm trying to concentrate over here, damn it.
This again is where a nice foam pad. I guess this is not a nice one anymore. This one's falling apart, but you can see that the sandpaper can flex, and so I can kind of get into the contours of this without creating any really hard edges. But yeah, I think we got that tear out. And I think we can move on to the next grit. We'll go up to 150 now. Able to refrain, be sure to watch my face and I'll give you the warning stare. Freefall. Yeah, I feel like the Bob Ross paintings, well, they were super painful during the process. I feel like those I can kind of be proud about, right? Because, I mean, nobody who doesn't have any painting experience is going to do, like, perfect or really well on the Bob Ross painting. So actually kind of took my time and we did okay on those. But the stream painting, the Microsoft painting, and I don't know, like if you've never done one of those either, especially if you haven't used any like of the advanced tools and you just like straight freehand penciled it,
I feel like that's kind of difficult too, but I'm definitely worse than the average person when it comes to that. So y'all don't know what we're talking about. A long time ago, we're like, well, the number of channel points increased over time until it eventually went away. A long, long time ago, we used to do this thing on stream that
for different paintings or different amount of channel points, you could do a painting and you could request something and I would do it on stream. I've still got them saved somewhere, but
they just got really ridiculous. I'm like, oh yeah, I want two dinosaurs eating at a picnic table in front of a waterfall, or I want a pterodactyl as a ballerina performing up on stage in a tutu, you know, or I don't even remember all of them. So I've tried to block out all of these memories, but it used to be a big thing on the screen, but got discontinued. And probably late, no, early 2022, I think. I think they made a short appearance in like January or February 2022 and then went away.
Painful. No. I wish they were paintful, but actual pain. Am I using Odie's on the bowl? That's a good question, D. I don't know. Obviously, I just opened the Odie's oil recently, so I haven't used it on any of my previous bowls, but I was thinking about maybe using it because it is a food safe finish. I have used in the past. What have I used? I've used mineral oil and beeswax. I have used the tried and true original, which is probably pretty similar to mineral oil and beeswax, but maybe got a few other things in it too. And I have used, oh yeah, this stuff here, this walnut oil. This Mahoney's walnut oil. This is good stuff too. But I don't know. I don't know, honestly. I may, because I really did like the finish that Odie's oil gave those bud vases for sure. What's up, Dirty Smith? How we doing today, buddy? Welcome in. That's a good question, D. It is about to be that time where we need to figure out what our finish is going to be. I may just use Odie's oil. I might. How you doing today, Dirty Smith? You having a good Tuesday so far? Tuesday? Did I say Tuesday? I meant Thursday.
I can't talk today, Dirty, so my brain is complete mashed potatoes. But don't listen to anything I say, but I do still hope that you're having a good day. Even though I don't know what day it is.
Oh, we want some wiggle butt. I love the finishes on the bud base. I did too. Let me finish up with this sanding. I've got a couple more grits to go. Let me sweep up a little bit
and we will bring those puppies out and get them a treat, Dirty. So thank you for redeeming it. Get them in just a sec. Jeez, I don't think they got a treat on Tuesday, so they're going to be excited. Walnut came out here a little bit earlier, and I think the puppies thought it was treat time. And they were a little sad. Be happy now. Oh yeah, Freaky, if you're still here. Oh, there you go. Oh, they got two treats on Tuesday?
Okay, well, my memory just sucks. Maybe it was Monday. I feel like one stream this week they didn't, but maybe it was Monday. Freaky, one of the last streams, Monday or Tuesday. Obviously, I don't know what day it is. Okay, I split the second one. I do recall this now. So it must have been Monday that they didn't get one. Freaky, but I finally got a hold of Triton support today for the router. They did say most likely it's the speed controller. So they were going to check and see if it's under warranty still. And if it is, fix it for me. But if not, they said that I can buy the speed controller. I think it's like $50, which is a lot, but at least it's not $250 that the new router would be. So, yeah, so hopefully, and they said it's super easy. It's just like three leads that you got to plug in
and screw it down. So yeah, hopefully we can
figure it out. Doing a lot better now? Good, Dirty. So there's a chance that I was right again? How is that possible?
You're a gosh darn genius, Freaky. Have fun. I may have said that sounding sarcastic, but it is the truth. It is the truth, Freaky. You know you're cool. You know, I mean, I've said it before.
Freaky May not have the degree, the piece of paper that says he's an engineer, but Freaky is 100% an engineer. So don't. No piece of paper can actually make you an engineer. In my mind, maybe it's some government or something. Wow, this thing is really coming apart here. Try and glue that down real quick. Try and save it. Get one last use out of it before I gotta trash it. Where's the CA glue? Oh, it's over here. Hold, please. Just start charging people for your advice. Everybody except for me, Freaky, right? Your good old friend Boyd. Remember? But I'll help. I'll give you like some great lines that you can put on your help website to say, Freaky helped me troubleshoot my router at A+ service. And you know, I'll give you some tags that you can use, and I'll start pointing people in your direction. Does that help? But you would be my best customer. Damn it. This is true. Because how many times over the past few years have you come to my rescue, Freaky? Damn it. All right. We'll have to think about that. Can I at least get a discount? Can I get a friends and family discount or something? Oh, I do need some activator, Random Tinker. You're not wrong. But I do need this. I feel like, it's not going to. Where is that darn activator? There it is. See if it'll just like go through the foam. Yeah, I really need to trash this thing. I think I've got another one, but it's foam pad. Oh, it's just like new. Look at that. Look at that. Soaked right into the foam. Perfect. Perfect. All right. I don't remember where I sanded in here, but I don't think I got very far. We're on 220 grit. I'm going to do one more grit at 320, and then we'll be done sanding. And we'll bring the puppos out. So, yeah, it is looking like, how long have you been trimming? 3 hours? Goodness. Well, we've made 3 bowls and 3 streams. Is that good? Am I doing good? Damn it. I really gotta step it up. Step up my game. But, all right, to be fair, I haven't turned bowls in a while, and we're doing some kind of complex shapes, so I've got an excuse, right? For now. Remember the first stream that I saw, you were trying to clamp something and struggle a bit, so I went to my shop to take a picture of how I would do it. And send it to you from day one, Freaky. From day one, you've had my back here. Yeah. Guys, you Freaky, doing stuff like that. I remember when, like, Sasaki first came in and we were talking about resin pouring and stuff. I mean, the only reason Sasaki did his first stream was he got so frustrated. He got so frustrated trying to tell me how to do resin stuff that he was just like, screw it, I'll just stream it and I'll show you everything of how to do resin. And that's how he got started. I do remember that, Freaky. I don't remember what I was trying to clamp. I was just kerning back in those days. So like, what? I don't know what I could have been clamping, but I do remember you sending me a picture. So young and innocent back then.
if that still exists in like Discord DMs. Or if that message still exists.
Activator commercial is brought to you by Boyd's Custom Fab. I need to get hooked up with a CA. You guys remember that? Who was that guy? Maker's Workbench? Who had a CA sponsor? Who was it? Not Stickfast, but
I can't remember who his CA sponsor was, but he would always give away CA glue in.
Allegedly. Oh. It was sandpaper and CA glue, I think. Allegedly, a lot of people never got their items. We won't go into all that because we don't need to drag people through the mud, but
apparently a lot of people, including Walnut, never got the packages. I'll just say that. And allegedly, I've got a very long history with him. I met him on Instagram many years before he actually came over to Twitch. Probably gonna
Starbond was it. You found the message, Freaky? What? Discord never does forget. You guys gotta watch out what you post in Discord. Not wrong. Oh, so smooth. Dang. I'm gonna have to look at that too then, Freaky. That's awesome. But nobody actually got it. Yeah. Yeah, you're still waiting in your sandpaper box. Right. Right, Walnut. Yeah. Yeah, it's not like I didn't know he was a little sketchy before then. Okay, anyway, we don't need to be dragging people's names through the mud like that. Maybe there was a reason. Maybe something happened and he couldn't. But anyway. Damn. Damn. October 31st. That was like, I don't even know. That was such a different, streaming was so different back then. And like, I had no idea what was going to happen. I just quit my job a couple months earlier. I quit my job, I guess, 6 months before then. At the end of June. At the end of June, I quit. So, like, yeah, we were, I guess, 3 months into streaming. But, yeah, I mean, what? We probably still had TTS, Freaky. We probably still, like, we're just on very, very simple streaming, I don't know, settings and stuff. It was just a different time. Fun time. Fun time, but definitely different. It's like you, Freaky, Chevy, maybe Sasaki by that point, Tatum. A lot of other people too, but people come and people go sometimes, but the real ones stick around. Caps it or preferred CA glue. Oh, yeah, he sells it. Parfix. Parfix is the glue that he uses. And it does seem like a really good product, but I have never used it myself. But yeah, he uses it like on the outside of bowls, and it seems to do pretty well to protect bowls and stuff. But I've never tried it myself. Oh, there's just some little scratches right there. This is why I couldn't make knives anymore. Like, if I see scratches in the piece, and especially I got to the point, I used to watch this guy named Walter Sorrells, who's a really famous knife maker. He would suggest that if you were going to sell your knives... What's up, KB Fibers? Welcome in. Good to see you. Hope you're having a good day so far. He suggested that if you were going to sell your knives, that you really needed to make sure all the scratches were out of them, and to go so far as to put on magnifying lenses. and actually look at the work. I still have those magnifying lenses over there, actually. And look at your blade, your knife blade, underneath the magnifying lenses, and get all the scratches out. Now, I don't know if y'all have ever looked at anything that you have sanded under magnification, but you see a lot of imperfections. And it's one thing to try and get those imperfections out on wood. It's another to try to get them out on hardened steel. So yeah, that was brutal. Couldn't do it anymore. Had to, especially that was like before I had air conditioning in my garage. That was before I had a whole lot of time. Yeah, it was not something I enjoyed for too long, but it was a good stepping stone. It was fun for the time being. Distribute for Parfix, yeah. Yeah, and like I said, it does seem like a good super glue. Something that you can use on pins and bowls and stuff, but I just haven't personally had a chance to use it. I've already got a problem with finishes and stuff, so maybe one day though. Not against it. Just haven't tried it yet. He makes really beautiful work. I'm pretty sure that this handle. Is that true? I don't know. He may have just sprayed it. But Caps gave me this handle right here. But I'm pretty sure he may have just sprayed it and not used Parfix. But yeah, he's the one who taught me that technique. He actually burns his, chars the handle, and that's how he gets the black coloring. Kind of opens up the grain a little bit more too, instead of just staining it black. My brain read that as Kappa. Is it distribute? Oh, yeah. Cap. What's up, Wolf Collar? You make it sound like metal is harder than wood? Maybe like that. It's maybe like that, Wolf Collar. I don't know. I haven't tested it yet. I haven't looked at any data, but I've got some speculation that maybe steel, especially tool steel that has been hardened in a forge and quenched in oil, maybe a little harder than wood. But I don't know. You got any insight, Wolf? Mecca's not here, so I can use my adjustable wrench, right? All right, let's let us Omega Lull. Damn, how much time we got? I said I wasn't going to do a 6-hour stream. And if I start on this one, we are going to. But I really do want to. I really do want to turn this one. But yeah, if I do this, we're going to end up going for way too long. Maybe I should. Maybe we should just start it. And then we'll finish it. We'll finish it tomorrow. Right? We'll just start on this one. We'll cut and we'll sand and we'll get it going. And then tomorrow will be finishing day. We'll use the vacuum truck and remove the tenon. We'll sand everything, get it all nice. And then tomorrow we will put the finish on all of our bowls. If you haven't seen the bowls that we finished this week, the other one is just a normal, the camera doesn't like this maple. This one is another unique design. You can see it's got like the curved bottom. I guess actually, whenever I look at him, pretty similar. This one just a little curvy. This one a little more bold lines, but relatively similar. This one's also going to have a little foot to it, but I like these. I like these new designs. They're a little more difficult than standard bowls, but let's do that. We'll go for another hour or so and get going on this one. This one was, of course, a log that I started. It was given to me by Junk Collector. Used to be a half of a log, right? You can kind of see the profile. Imagine the bark kind of rounded out here. So we carved in on this side and then rounded out this side. And I started this, I turned it the first time back in September of last year. To allow it to dry. And I don't know 100% that it's dry, but I'm going to go ahead and assume that it's pretty dry. So even if it warps a little bit, I don't think it'll be too bad. Hammer did send my dad to the hospital for stitches. He dropped it on his head. Yikes. But was it a wood handled hammer, Wolf, and or was it the metal part that hit him? But yeah, that sounds rough. It's not good. Kitty came up for a visit. Hi, Kitty. iPhone kept wanting to correct it to Kappa 2. Y'all are on Twitch too much. What did I do with the wrench, Momo? I didn't do anything. I used it correctly. But Mechaform hates adjustable wrenches. He hates these wrenches that have this little adjustment to be able to move it, you know, adjust the wrench to the size that you need. Mecha is a really big fan of, I don't know, standard fixed wrenches that fit perfectly the size. You know, obviously these are all sized. This one is a 14 millimeter wrench. But yes, I did use it to loosen the chuck, right? You can see that this is pretty big. The nut or whatever, the insert, it's got a pretty big size, and I don't have a wrench big enough for that. So I bought this adjustable wrench to be able to do it. And Mecha does have a great point in that using an adjustable wrench can round off the corners. And because it's not perfectly sized, over time you can start to round off the corners and it can ruin the nut or whatever. But I don't know. I'm not perfect. I'm not a perfect person. I can only do so much. I can only have so many wrenches. My name is not Wrenches Woodworks. So I can only have so many wrenches. I can only have so many routers. Metal party's putting it away, but missed the pegs. They had to pack me up. My sister in the garage in the hospital. Wow. Proud to tell my mom is not happy with them. Yikes. Yeah, that doesn't seem too good. Doesn't seem too good at all. See if we can get this thing back on the lathe. I don't know exactly what kind of wood this is, but I think I see the dimple in the back. There it is. Where was the dimple on the front? There's the one on the back. Now, can we find the dimple on the front? I think that was it. I think it just fit in. Let's see. So this thing, of course, as it was sitting there and drying, it's probably going to have warped a little bit and moved. But you can see we didn't get any cracks, which is really good. These things can have a tendency to crack and have issues as they're drying out, kind of like this one here, right? You can see this one got a big old crack on the end grain as it was drying, and that pretty much ruined that one. So this one looks good though, and hopefully it's dry enough to where I can turn it and not have a lot of warping afterwards, but we'll see. You figure out if my mom freaked out about being in the hospital or driving with a head injury? Yeah, neither seem real good. A nut that size is never going to round off much so much you can't grip it. Yeah, I think for that one, 1010, that's not the real thing that triggers him. It's probably more like my CNC. The nut and the spindle on it. I've been allegedly caught using a adjustable wrench on that, and just for various other things that really probably shouldn't have an adjustable wrench on there, but that's because Boyd already rounded them over. It is better than channel locks. Thank you, Freefall. See, that's being positive, because we could also use these channel locks here. Well, we could be using these, right? These are channel locks. Those are another way of grabbing and loosening or tightening, I guess, bolts. But I don't use those, okay? Those are for special use only. So what are we gonna do? Are we going to treat this? I guess we'll just treat this like a normal bowl. We will tidy up the tenon. I'm gonna have to move this a little closer. Hold please. Move cameras. Adjusting cameras. This is a little small bowl. All right, better. So you can see I made a really large tenon, and that's important because now I can come back. That tenon is also going to have warped and misshapen a little bit, so I can come back and make the smaller tenon that'll fit my smaller chuck. Yeah, we'll be able to fit that, get a good grip on it, and we'll also shape the outside. Hopefully the bark doesn't come off. I think I will be able to save the bark. In a couple areas, like right there, I put some CA glue. It looked like the bark was starting to lift. But I don't think the bark look is for everybody. But I think it's a unique way to show that this was turned from a log, right? And you may say, well, Boyd, all bowls are turned from a log. I know. But instead of being a nice blank like this one, I didn't start out with something like this. I started out with an actual log that had bark on it, and I don't know. I think it's kind of cool. So I'm going to do that. It gives it kind of an organic shape. This was out of a crotch piece, so you can kind of see. A little hard to tell, but it's got one trunk, and then this split out into two branches like that. So that's kind of gives it its unique shape rather than just an oval like this one that typical tree logs look like. Words are hard right now, but maybe I'm making a little bit of sense. And this one is meant to be a hat, of course. Nice. No worries. Oh, wait, Cole's on tonight. Nice. Welcome back, Tom. Wrenches seem bad and complicated. Just use your hands. That's right, Mama. You can always get things tight enough with your hands. No worries at all. Bowley Boyd, not Bordy Boyd tonight. That's right, Tom. We've been on the bowl game all week. You missed the other bowl walnut, and this actually fits. Okay, well, just as I say that, it falls off. But here, walnut. Man, this looks pretty sick. I feel like I could rock this with a new haircut. This is it, Walnut. We still need to take off the tenon. But I think this will look pretty good. We got the inside pretty well sanded and finished, so yeah. KB, you like the bark on it? D, you like the bark on it too? Nice. Well, I'm glad y'all like it. Colleen was actually the first one to buy. She bought my very first live edge bowl. I was in love with it. And I'm really glad that it went to Colleen as well. Yeah, these are a lot of work, right? Going from a log to this, waiting months or sometimes even years for it to dry out and then be able to turn it into this. So it is a lot of work that goes into these, but I think they're kind of cool, a little bit different. What's for dessert? I don't know, Tatum, you tell me. Walnut apparently got some ice cream. We haven't had ice cream in our freezer for a long, long time. And Walnut apparently got some ice cream from the grocery store a couple days ago. So that's what's going to be for dessert for me tonight. But I don't know about for you, Tatum. Food talk, really? Ricky, you already missed it earlier. We were talking all about food, but I've kind of forgotten about it. Should I eat some more peanut brittle for you, Freaky? I wish it wasn't such a pain to send food overseas, Freaky, and I would send you some peanut brittle. I heard you use an analogy to it the other day, but... Alice in Wonderland, welcome in. It's nice showing the natural shape. I prefer leaving some bark and smoothing it off, if possible, a bit off-center. Lathing is nice. Yeah, that's awesome. Alice, first off, thanks for being here. Thanks for the first-time chat. And if you would like to share any of your work... And have any pictures, even if it's like a link to Instagram, or if you want to post some pictures in our Discord, feel free to do any and all of the above. And would love to check out your work. But yeah, that's awesome. This will only be my, well, if I complete it, it will only be my second Live Edge Bowl. I showed you guys that other one that cracked. I think that's right. Yeah, I think this will only be my second ever Live Edge Bowl. I've got a few more logs over there that I want to turn, but I just haven't gotten around to it yet. Cherry Bowl is sweet. Thanks, Dean. Thank you. Thank you. I could even use that bowl with the crack. Oh, my hat. Yes. I may finish that one day. I think what happened is I made the bottom a little too small. I jumped in. Camera four. I jumped in and started turning this before I really had any practice. Yeah, you can see that ring right there started to get really, really thin. I think whenever it was on the lathe, I could actually see light. I could actually see light through the wood. It got so thin. So my idea was to maybe fill it with resin, kind of like I did with this one here. But I made a nice funnel. Y'all heard me talking about funnels earlier. This was a nice cherry funnel that I made that I filled with resin, but I need to go back and actually finish this one as well. But yeah, I think in order to finish this one, I'm gonna have to fill it with some resin or something to try and get it done. Wonder I look so fat on camera. Freaky, don't be too hard on yourself, bud. You look great. I scream, you scream, we all scream. Fry scream. Let's go. Just had chili? Dang, that does sound good. It actually did get cooler here today. I think it's going to get down into the 30s Fahrenheit tonight,
where it had been in the 80s for, earlier this week. So I'm told we have Aldi tiramisu and cookie dough ice cream. Dang, that sounds good, Tatum. Cookie dough is one of my favorite ice creams. Tiramisu is also very delicious too. So I don't think I've ever seen that at Aldi. We gotta step up our Aldi game. All right, let's turn this on and just see what it's like. It's a little wobbly right now, but let's mark out our new tenon. Yeah. Do it like, man, this is, maybe let's flatten this out. Let's flatten this out first and then we'll make our tenon. One step at a time. I haven't turned too many of these, so we're going to be kind of in exploratory land. I don't think that makes sense, but live edge means it has the bark removed entirely or the wood maintains the character of the original tree's shape. But it hasn't had the bark removed. Yes. Yes, correct. Thank you. Thank you for answering that, Alice. Yep, so that's what we're going for here. Not a traditional bowl, but something that can maybe be used as a decorative piece. Maybe a little small fruit bowl or something like that. So, but that wood is really light. Look how light it is compared to what it looks like when it's got, this is all wax that's on the outside. And I kind of use that to help keep it drying relatively consistently and so it doesn't crack. All right. So let's now mark our tenon. That'll be where we put that. Let me try and move y'all just a little bit closer. How long have you been turning, Alice? I've only been doing this for about 2.5 years at this point, and not fully focused on turning either. Got recently, especially, been doing more like cutting boards and like wall-mounted bottle openers and all different kind of stuff. But I started out streaming pretty much exclusively turning. It's been kind of off and on in the past year or so. I'm just going to say resin the bottom. Yeah. Yeah, I just need to actually do it. One of those things that I know what I need to do. I just haven't taken the time to actually do it.
You're making a nice stitch marker bowl. Interesting. Well, maybe we can try and make something for you, KB. I have in the past. I'll show you. I've only made one. Work to walk the screaming beast. Okay, Momo. Blah blah blah. Gallery. I'll show you the one and only yarn bowl that I made. And I haven't made one since, but I did
make this one out of maple for our friend Mitchell. Mitchell Loom Knitter. Maybe her name is Mitchell Fiber Arts now. Yeah, I made that one last year. And I need to kind of get back into those. It was a challenge for sure, because doing that cutout and trying to make that smooth and nicely shaped or whatever was a big challenge. But I did enjoy making that. I know we've got a lot of fiber artists out there who maybe I can make some yarn bowls for. So maybe this year after we take care of a few things and get going for the year, maybe we'll make it a point to make some more yarn bowls.
The no yeet Thursday, so you're good. Thank you, Tatum. Thanks for reinforcing that. There's a lot of people trying to scream for a yeet earlier and it's getting a little nervous, but I'm hoping that's the case, Tatum. Because I don't want to eat this one. I want to get another live edge bowl out there. 6 months experience 10 years ago. I do a lot of research, though. That's amazing. That's awesome. Like I said, if you do have an Instagram or something, no pressure at all. But I would love to check out the work that you've done so far. But, you know, so the lathe is something that I had no idea it was as versatile as it is. Here, let me stop on the bottom a little bit. But I've loved the amount of projects I've been able to make, and I bounced a lot between, this is a little tenon tool. You can see it's cut at an angle to be able to make it a little easier to make the dovetailed tenon. Of course, this tool, as I was mentioning earlier, given to me by Caps Creations. So yeah, really nice little tool to help out with the tenons, the dovetailed tenons for sure. Anyway, we've kind of bounced around a bunch of different projects, but I've been pleasantly happy with the versatility and like being able to, make as much as I have, or much of the possibilities with the lathe, I guess. Thanks, KB. Thanks, Alice. Yarn balls or yarn balls? Leah, I think you're just hearing my Texan accent come out a little bit. My yarn balls. Let's try and rough this out. This is not smooth at all right now. But try and rough this out mostly. See where we're at and finish up the cuts a little smoother, hopefully. Super light though. It's almost yellow. I don't remember if Junk Collector was here, he would tell me what kind of wood this is, but yeah, it's very yellow, which is interesting. If anybody's got any guesses on what kind of wood this is, let me know. It does probably help to have the bark. It does still feel a little green. It's a little worrisome. But again, I think worst case is it's gonna warp a little bit more. But hopefully it's dry enough. Nice dye finish. Yeah, Alice, that was a technique that Caps uses. It requires an open-grained wood like ash or oak.
And his process, actually, he will char. He'll char the ash and then spray it with a little lacquer and then come back and grain fill to give it that look. So Hampshire Sheen is the wax. I've got a little bit of it, and I've done a few projects with it myself. But I'll show you the can real quick if you're interested. I don't actually char it. I tried that first, and it's very messy. Or it's not very messy. It's very smoky, right? And in a little garage environment like this, it was not the most pleasant. So I actually just stain it. I use some water-based stain, just black stain. I get it from General Finishes, but probably whatever black stain would work. And then I use the wax. And this is all it is here. So it's called Embellishing Paste Wax. I got the purple, the green, and the gold. And I think all of them look pretty good. Yeah, it's just kind of like a thick... I think it's actually a petroleum-based wax. But yeah, it does a really good job of filling in the grain. Kind of giving you that cool effect. And I've also, instead of black, I think on one or two of the bowls that I made with it, I stained it blue. And then came back with like green grain fill or something like that. So checking it out on Google. Yeah, sounds good. I think there's only like one or two people who sell it. And it is a little pricey, but a little bit. It's one of those things, a little bit goes a long way. I also, they travel around to a lot of different turning conventions. And so I will always stock up and get one or two whenever we go to the one here in Texas. So, yeah, definitely, you know, if you don't want to pay the shipping or you're planning on going to a turning convention soon, maybe see if they're going to be there. Is it pine? I don't think it's pine, D. Pine would be a lot softer than this, I think. And hopefully it's not pine, but I don't know. The shape of this bowl reminds me of paint palette board. Yeah, kind of. So much goo. Got to get your different colors of goo, Momo. Got to get the purple goo, the green goo, gold goo, all the oo goo. I'll see. I kind of want to keep that little, bark inclusion or something there. I don't know if we're actually going to be able to keep it, but that's kind of a cool little feature. A rainbow of goo. A goobo. Exactly. Exactly. I think there's a few wood chips in this drink here. All right. Extra fiber.
Extra minerals. All the things. But it's always important to check. This view is better. Always important to spin the lathe before you, or whenever you adjust your tool rest to make sure it's not going to hit. Yeah, I think the bark inclusion would be cool if we can keep it. We'll see though. Yeah, Alice, if you've never done green bowls, I just found this material at my local park. And they had it labeled as firewood. Actually, not this. This was given to me by Junk Collector, but. The first bowls that I did, and that one that cracked, I actually found that stuff just at the park. The only problem is it takes a long time for it to dry out. And you kind of have to invest some time to, like, once turn it, let it dry for a few months, and then come back and turn it for the second time. So that is maybe kind of why I haven't done it more. I kind of like the... I do this as a business and full-time making and stuff, and sometimes the idea of turning something and then having to wait a few months to like see the return on it, maybe even up to a year, it just hasn't been that attractive to me whenever I can, you know, pay for the material and then be able to make something and instantly, you know, pay for some kiln dried wood and be able to instantly make, you know, a return on it. So, but I don't know. Maybe this year we'll actually spend some time, especially in the beginning of the year, and maybe try to have some stuff ready for Christmas. never too early to be preparing for Christmas or the holiday rush. So, I don't know. Maybe we'll think about it. Oh, I didn't do puppy time. Dang it.
Darty Smith, are you still here? Oh, man. I feel bad. I hope Darty Smith is still here. Dang it. Honestly, that's why I shouldn't delay it too much, because I always forget. I owe Darty Smith I'll give them a full treat. But I think I gotta wait for Darty Smith to come back. Don't think about Christmas until you take the skellies away? That's true. That's true, Tatum. That means the skellies are gone. If they've come and gone, that means that we're getting real close to Christmas, so... That's Tatum's landmark. Oh my goodness. Dang it. I forgot puppy time. Now I feel bad.
Now I feel bad. I gave Darty Smith my word. And I messed up. Rip. Alright. Let's keep going. With a pot of goo gold at the end of the goo bow. Most material I've used was apple cherry cut off the trees in the backyard. Awesome. Awesome. That's having free material, especially if you're just learning and all that stuff, it's great. And not ruining that wood that you paid good money for. I think some of the bark just came off, but we'll see how much later. It'll be a surprise. More bark just came off. Yeah, this one we may lose a lot of the bark. Oh yeah, huge piece came off at the top here. So RIP to the bark. Had a good run. Yeah, you can see it's gonna come off on this side too. So that's fine. We'll just we'll have a uniquely shaped bowl. It just won't have any bark. So. Hope y'all didn't fall too much in love with the bark, because not gonna be a barky bowl, unfortunately. Give them the points back, thanks on it. Who is there? Who's there? Uh-huh. Like, boom! Look at that handsome guy right there. Let's go! Let's go! What's up, Double R? Dang, my headphones are super low right now. I didn't hear that until halfway through. I didn't hear you come in until the first boom! What's up, Double R? Happy Thursday, my dude. Welcome in. Hope all has been well with you. Been having a good week. Happy Almost Friday. Looking forward to playoff weekend, Double R? I mean, you really... And it's a good thing I got a face shield on right now, because this thing is sketchy. I'm sure you're extra looking forward to playoff weekend, because your Eagles aren't playing, and they got a bye, so no risk. No risk, right?
All bowl, no bark. You're exactly right. You're 100% right. We gotta get this dog. We gotta toughen this dog up right here. Oh my goodness. Turn on the dust collector, because there's dust everywhere. Yeah, I'm covered. I've been, the thing with bowls is, and like, especially I use the apron here, but I mean, if I just go digging around in this apron real quick, yeah, this thing just collects it. Anyway, the nice thing about it, at least, is it doesn't get, I say that, but it is all over my clothes. Anyway, it doesn't get everywhere. But I will find some that it got under my collar. You'll see some turners. They've got like a special shirt that like buttons up here, and it makes it really tight around their neck, tight around their arms. Some people even go as far as putting little Caps actually does this. If you ever see Caps' streams, he's got like a little hood. I cannot balance on one leg. Hold on, let me do that again. Okay, I really can't. All right, we can balance on one leg. He's got a hood around his like ankle that will keep sawdust from going in your shoes. Cause yeah, looking down right now, I've got a bunch in there. So, yeah. I wouldn't worry about the bark. It's going really far off. It's going to really fall off in the dishwasher anyway. That's what I'm saying, Alice. How could he? Don't worry about Tintin, though, Alice. He's just a troll who wants to get a rise out of you. He knows better than that. He better not be putting... I just sent him a bowl, actually. He better not be putting that in the dishwasher. A week full of stressless football. I bet. That sounds really nice, Double R. I got a bad, bad feeling that the Cowboys are about to lose to the... Oh, man, I think I may just need to pry this off right now. This bark is going to come slap me in the face if I don't. What should I use? Should I use a chisel? Should I use a... Maybe I'll use one of these. Let's use the... Where's that small chisel that I got? We'll just use this. Yeah, I feel like the Cowboys are about to lose to the... To Tampa Bay. I got a bad feeling. I know I'm not the only one. Dust Daddy. Man glitter for everyone. That's right. That's right. But sacrifice that we got to pay. Oh, that was pretty satisfying. Look at that big chunk. Wear a tie so tight. So it's tight around your neck and chips don't go down your shirt. Damn it. Tintin wants me to be dressed in my Sunday best out here every stream. Every time. Every time. I can never do right by Tintin. Ooh. All right, that's a little dangerous. That's maybe a little dangerous. What's up, Swiss Forge? Hazmat suit would solve this problem? Why don't you show me how that's done, Swiss Forge? That sounds really... Hazmat suit sounds really comfortable. Whenever you're standing right by a forge. It sounds like it's going to be a very cool suit to wear, not hot at all. Swiss Forge, you first. You lead the way. Maybe I'll follow. Those legs are not for sale. Yeah, no, Double R. Belong to the thruple only. Boyd, I'm unfollowed and it won't let me follow again. I have been booted. No doubt. I did see the other day that it looked like you had to refollow. I was wondering if maybe I hurt your feelings, but I didn't unfollow, but somehow. Dang. How rude. How rude of Twitch. Okay, my Seahawks are most likely going to lose to the Niners. Yeah, that's going to be a tough game. The Niners are really good, Raw, especially now with Christian McCaffrey. That's going to be tough, but Raw, hope you're having a good day. No doubt. I don't think I've seen you since your raid on Monday. I can't remember when it was, no doubt. But the guy that you raided into, Haas something, that dude was cracking me up that night. I went back and watched some of his other VODs. And it seems like, I'm guessing, you know, I heard a story maybe that he used to like own or Haas Caddy. Haas Caddy is that person. Maybe he used to like own or help run a bar back in the day. But I'm guessing that he used to do entertainment. He's like amazing at the keyboard. He is amazing with his vocals and how he can like loop stuff in and just make songs. It was crazy. But whenever he was playing, what was that guy's name? And don't look up this person unless you are very okay with like very raunchy stuff. Wheeler Walker Jr. is that guy's name. Whenever he was playing Wheeler Walker, oh my God, I was cracking up. I have never heard those before. Actually, I got to send those to my brother because my brothers are the type of people who really like that kind of sick music. But oh my God, I was laughing out loud sitting at my computer by myself. But it sounded like I went and listened to his other stuff and it sounded like, you know, he does a lot of, I think he went from that Wheeler Walker to gospel is his range of music and stuff. But absolutely had me rolling, with some of the music he was playing. So, but yeah, super talented. I was impressed. So thanks for introducing him to your community and us over there. So Butch did that to me with C-Not Bush. I've been subbed to him longer than I'm following. Yikes. Does Boyd know what a thruple is? Yeah, I do, Momo. Or at least I think I know. Double R, it wasn't by choice. I tried to not do the buzz cut, but tough times and not wanting to go to the barber led to this. And, well, I couldn't make it look good by myself. Walnut tried to come save it, and it was just too much work. So I just decided to send it straight down the middle with the guard. And this is what we ended up with. I hope I didn't disappoint you too much, Double R. Hazmat suits and their loose glove sleeves are great for rotating machinery. Absolutely, yeah. What's wrong with getting a glove or a sleeve or any of that caught into a lathe? Seems very safe. Very, very safe. Niners are pretty good. Yeah, yep. Yeah. Oh, are pretty good. Damn it, Double R. I didn't get that until Raw said something. He used to be a dueling piano player, and he's an ex-heroin addict. Fun and positive dude, yeah. I actually went and listened to like a couple, like a VOD or two of his from the past. And definitely, I like his vibe and what he's doing on his stream as well. So good perspective, it seems. Random Tinker, of course you do, Random Tinker. Of course you like Wheeler Walker. That definitely seems like your type of humor too. But yeah, you Hoss Caddy, let's see if I can shout him out real quick. Again, I don't think he does Wheeler Walker very often, but and I wouldn't suggest, again, Momo, don't go listen to Wheeler Walker, and maybe just because I told you to, but don't. I'm telling you, Momo, trust me, it is not a Momo approved. He's not a Momo approved guy, all right? Not for Momo's ears. I do what I want. All right, Momo. Go listen to Wheeler Walker, but don't tell me I didn't say so. That looks good. I cut my own hair as well. You know, no doubt. I did this. Oops. I did this back in 2020, right before Christmas. And I don't know. I was looking at my pictures of myself back then, and I was like, man, I don't really like the full buzz cut, but I also don't want to like spend the money. I don't like the whole haircutting experience. Money is one of the things, but I don't like talking to random people and having to have small talk with somebody who I know nothing about. I don't want to tell them about my life. I don't want to hear about their life. That's probably a little rude, but it's the truth. I don't want to sit in the chair and like have to sit there with all the smells and the things that come with sitting in a barbershop. It's just not for me. So I decided that we were just going to try and cut our own. And this is what we ended up with. So I cut my own hair for 14 years. Hey, sounds good, Tatum. Thanks for stopping by, buddy. We'll talk to you later, Tatum. Appreciate you being here. Thanks for the support. And we'll chat with you later, Tatum. I'll let you know if Walnut sent that package today. I'll send you a tracking number. But yeah, we'll see, Double R. We'll keep practicing. Keep practicing. Would Teddy approve of it? I don't know. I feel like Teddy's ears are just as fragile as Momo's, and I wouldn't want to be responsible for introducing him to those kind of words and stuff that old Wheeler Walker puts out there, but I don't know. I'm not Teddy's mama or mama's or Teddy's daddy.
And I can't tell Teddy what to do, but as a friend of Momo's, I can tell her that I don't think Wheeler Walker is gonna be her style. But maybe so. Who knows? Who knows? But how do you know what Momo is into? Shouldn't be assuming. All right. 1010, do you know who Wheeler Walker is? You know who that is? Go take a listen. If not, 1010, I'll encourage you to just listen to a couple of his most famous songs, and I think you'll understand. Ryan is still a little wobbly, so we're not quite round, I don't think. Try and finish rounding it out and then switch to the inside. And I can almost feel the coolness of the shavings coming off, which is probably not a good sign as far as dryness goes, because really the shaving should be hot and dry, but I guess we'll see. Maybe the Momo you see on Twitch is just the front, you know? You know, Random Tinker, there are two different Momos. There is Chat Momo, which is a little spicy. Can sometimes like to yell and be loud in chat. And then there is Stream Momo. So you're not wrong, RT. I don't know if anybody actually knows. Wait, Hoscaddy is following now? What's up, Hoscaddy? If you're actually here right now, welcome in. I was just talking to No Doubt Big Trout and saying how much I was enjoying your stream the other night and how you had me cracking up to Wheeler Walker. So, yeah, dude, super talented. I was really impressed with your stream. How you, I don't know, mix in all the songs and all that stuff. So, hell yeah. We're famous now. We made it, guys. We got a famous musician now following us. What's up, LiDAR? How we doing? Good to see you today, bud. Hope you're having a good day, LiDAR. Got my own hair, but it's more of a self-soothing gesture. If you have longer hair, Lee, I feel like it's maybe a little easier, but maybe I'm wrong, too. I don't know who he was. I didn't know who he was until I just Googled him, but now I'm well aware. So, 1010, what's your verdict? Would Momo like Wheeler Walker, or do you think Wheeler Walker is a little out of Momo's comfort zone? I know, LiDAR. I'm not sure if the inclusion's gonna stay with us or if it's gonna be gone by the time we turn this down, but we'll see. So we had to give you a shout out if you're still here. I had to give you a shout out to let everybody know the talent and the hilarity that ensued whenever I heard you playing Wheeler Walker, and thank you again for the introduction to him. All right, let's come back here and let's do a little sharpening as we try to finish out the outside of that pole. Really curious what wood that is. Again, if anybody's got any guesses on what wood that could potentially be. Junk Collector might know. He's the one who gave me the blank, but we'll see. I was really hoping that it would be a bark on the bowl, but it doesn't look like we're going to be able to save the bark, unfortunately. I'm hungry. I'm real hungry. I don't know if we'll fully get done with this one, but Hoscaddy is streaming. Whoa, that's awesome. Yeah, y'all should check him out. He's got a good vibe. As No Doubt Big Trout said, he's very open about his previous problems with addiction, and like tries to encourage other people who are struggling with things to get help or just have some like positive things to try to, you know, tell others what helped him through addiction. Got a good vibe going on over there. Got a great story about Wheeler Walker. I'll share on stream. Hell yeah, Random Tinker. I want to hear it. Teddy is the roughest, toughest, my inspiration. He best also very in touch with his bork motions. His bork motions. Goodness. Made a Shirley Temple. I need fluids. Yes. Yeah, that definitely works. I just, you know Gary V, right, Momo? I just actually saw, I don't know if it was a YouTube short or what it was. Maybe it was the one time I got on Instagram recently, but he had a short on mocktails. And how mocktails could be a huge industry going forward. So, interesting you brought that up. But a lot of people are investing in the future of alcoholless drinks, tasty drinks at bars, I guess. Makes sense. Thanks for the lurk, though, Alice. Sorry, I'm really behind on chat right now, but appreciate you stopping by, Alice. Hope to see you again soon, but yeah, take it easy. He's an icon for sure. Super cute, very cuddly, and very soft. I love him. That is what every lady wants and needs. Oh, goodness. I kind of like the flat bottom look of this, right? We just have a pretty flat bottom. And then some wings. I could bring it up a little bit more, but it's actually pretty thin right here at the top. I don't know if y'all can really see. But pretty thin here, so... I don't want to take off any more at the top until we go to the inside. Love me a good mocktail. Doesn't hurt my tongue. Yeah. Yeah, it's not something that I've had too many of. Unless it was as a kid. Maybe y'all, some of y'all have this experience too. As a kid, I went to some like all-inclusive. My parents brought me to some all-inclusive. Like, I don't know. Resorts or whatever. And obviously couldn't drink, so had to order the margaritas and the pina coladas without alcohol. Wanted to though. I was a good boy. I don't think I ever drank whenever I was like 13. It had like a sip of beer, but flat bottom girls, flat bottom bowls. It's the same. So, really wanna. Little tear out up here. But you can see whenever I'm turning at the top, look how much space there is. I'm hitting here, air, 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 hitting here, air, air, air. Maybe really at the top, top. It's really only this wing that I'm hitting. See? So it has to go through all that air, and if I push really hard, it will it'll get stuck and bad things will happen. Big yeets will happen. I do see some bad tear out though. Double large, you work out today, bud? So what was on the menu today? Never been to an all-inclusive resort. Wonder if I'd enjoy it. Buffet for sure, but what else? Yeah, I mean, like, so they have obviously the buffet, like all you can eat. They've got breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks in between, and you can just kind of go in and graze whenever you want. They have like swim-up bars, or they have actual dedicated bars that you can go to, and you can get drinks, and you know, typically you all go for the alcoholic variety, but you don't have to. You can just get non-alcoholic drinks. But the other thing it comes with is entertainment. So they'll have like pretty much every night they'll have different shows. Sometimes it's for the kids and it's like kind of silly stuff, but they'll have you know, people singing or people performing and stuff. And it's just all, it's nice because it's all right there just within, you know, the one area. So you can, you don't really have to leave the resort ever. And typically they'll have, access to the beach and all of that. So it's nice. I really enjoyed it. Juana and I went, my friend's parents are from Mexico. And so they go pretty much every year, I think. And they know like really good spots and where to go in town. And we had the absolute best tacos for sure. Yeah, we went with them and it was a good time. Yeah, it was a real good time. Wish we could go back, but fortunately that was whenever we were making money. Snacks, Gray's, yeah. Yeah, one of them had a taco place, too. Now you could just literally go in, get all the tacos that you wanted. And they don't really have a tipping culture, so
You don't even really have to tip. It's just all included with the with your meals or with your plan and stuff. So we ate so many tacos. Some of the hot sauces were super spicy though. They would wreck you.
Easier to plan a price point too. Yeah, that's another great thing, Freefall. You go and you know exactly how much you're going to spend. At least if you stay
on the resort, right? So it may look kind of expensive on paper, but when you consider all that you're getting, I think they're pretty good deals. Yeah, absolutely. Budgeting lets you easily budget things out.
Maybe near future, fingers crossed, your growth on Twitch has seemed pretty good. Maybe. Maybe, Momo. I mean, yeah. These numbers down here, thanks to you guys, are
wild. Yeah. I don't know. I don't even know what to say about that. Got a lot of things we need to get in order before we go on a huge vacation, but maybe it'll be possible to at least go on one vacation soon. We shall see.
Stream the vacation business trip. Dang.
Now we're thinking, Momo. Now we're thinking. Would be fun, though. Tatum's not here anymore, but he introduced me to a guy. I love
hanging out in people's streams. And obviously, there's a ton of makers and crafting art people that I love to meet. That's who I typically raid to. But sometimes, just like whenever I was talking about No Doubt Big Trout raiding into Hoscaddy, sometimes, like, those off-the-wall people who maybe you follow as a individual but aren't necessarily in the makers and crafting art community, I
sometimes really enjoy those raids to see who else is out there. And Tatum raided into a guy named Japandy Jones. And he is a streamer who does IRL streaming. But
he typically, I don't know if he only stays in Asia. I think he's originally American, but he goes around different spots in Asia. He'll be in Japan sometimes. I don't know where he's at right now. Where is he? In Thailand? Somewhere like that.
But he just, like, he'll go into bars and kind of, like, chat with people or walk around the street and kind of, like, go into different shops and stuff. And I don't know, it's just really interesting.
Tom thinks, yeah, exactly. Exactly like that, Momo. Yeah.
I love those kind of different raids sometimes that people go on. I probably need to, like, every now and then do that, too. I spend so much time watching Makers and Crafting that there's only a handful of people outside of this community that I watch, but yeah, it's funny. It's funny to see what else is out there on Switch.
We always joke around about the, you know, the what's it called?
Hot sub streamers, but there's a lot of other just chatting and streamers out there who are doing good stuff. This may not be in our direct community.
I guess Sasaki was the most famous for it, for always introducing us to
DJs and stuff. But I haven't hung out in DJ streams in a while since Sasaki. I haven't been seeing him too much. Or he hasn't been streaming or whatever. I think I'll raid Amaranth one day. That may be a streamer that I pass on. Maybe not Ammo Momo, but maybe you should. I think that would be a great raid for you, Momo. Maybe. Anyway, I'm saying talking about this. I was telling Owen, you guys know Owen.
Owen is trying to raise money to go to Makers Central. There's a link there if you want to look at more information and consider donating to it. But I asked Owen on his stream yesterday if he was going to be doing a hot tub stream
whenever or if we hit the goal. He's trying to raise 3,000 pounds in order to do this. And I think he's, last time I checked, he was 10% of the way there. So getting there.